Hello, everybody, and welcome to day 17 of our 8-bit RPG series. We're just getting streamed live on a Sunday morning. We're going to let people filter in. I'm going to drink some coffee, and in a few short minutes, we're definitely going to get to work. I'm going to get my system up and running while we wait. You can watch me do that. I know how exciting that is. We're going to be continuing off where we left yesterday, which was transition screens and some cleanup, right? Yesterday we fixed our shared inventory bag. We updated our save files to reflect that. Today we're going to be implementing hopefully two things. We also started implementing our leveling frame in the character UI so that we can see what abilities we have and what are available. Now that I have that, I think we're going to go to the next step of our leveling pane. Well, first of all, we're gonna get some buttons in here to go so that we can flip through the two panes, because that's important. We wanna be able to see that. So we'll get that in first. And then I wanna finish the leveling system, because we haven't really finished it. And that means there's gonna be leveling points you get every time you level up. And then you can spend those leveling points on abilities that your characters have available to them as they go. Now the question I have to decide is, in the leveling pane, do we show all of their abilities from level 1 to max and just have them grayed out because you can't afford them yet and you don't meet like minimum level requirements? Or do we wait and only give them to you when you hit the required level? So there's gonna be some refactoring to do today as I make that decision. Hey Rad, how's it going? How's my fun Sunday fun day going? It's fun so far. That's because we haven't done any work yet. I'm sure it's not gonna be as fun as I would like it to be. But that's all right, it'll be okay. How you guys doing this morning? Happy pun day. Happy pun day. I think working on the leveling system will be fun. There's some refactoring we're going to do to make it all happen, et cetera. So we'll see how that goes. And then apart from that, once that's finished, I want to then work on the post-battle UI, where we show how much experience you've gained. If anyone levels up, right, we'll show something there that, hey, you leveled up, yay! Here's what you get for leveling up. That type of stuff, I think that's important. And also if any gear drops from loot tables after the combat, we want to show it there so you can decide if you want to put it into your inventory or not. Let you decide what you want to do with it. Oh, that's some good coffee. So, where are we at? I gotta send my tweet out now. I'm gonna go do that right this moment. Day 17, guys. I can't believe we made it to day 17 already. Okay. That is everything I want, yep. Yeah, day 17, we do about 4 hours a day on this project. So we're getting close. We're almost at about 80 hours. We're just shy of 80 hours after today. I think we're at like 60 hours right now. So we got 64 or something like that, yeah. So that's not bad. That's not bad for the progress we've made from scratch. Obviously, we've started from nothing, right? Remember, we started from nothing. Making it all the way to where we are right now. It's not bad, not bad. Okay, let's make sure that I have merged all our branches and we'll be ready to go today. That's correct. We have a change. Why is this file All right, so I'm going to ignore and I'm going to stop tracking it. I think what's going on is this file was added to the repo before I added vc.dv to our gitignore, so it's being tracked currently. So I just need to make sure this gets removed. So let me commit that, even though I'm not going to keep it on master, because we actually don't make changes to master. We're going to create a branch here called level up. And then we'll go back to master, and we'll do a hard reset to get rid of that change in the master branch. So all we have to deal with now is the level up branch. Okay. Yum, yum, yum. Let's also make sure the game is still in a working state from where we left it off yesterday. Okay, yes. Here's all the fun gear we've gotten from combat. We can swap between heroes. Perfect. I wonder if I should move this up to the top. That almost make a little more sense. We might do that. Okay, if I select him, we show that. There's Rappy. Select you, we'll just show Rappy. Okay, good. Oh, interesting. Hold on, let me check something. If I go in here, Rappy. Okay, that was just... I was just freaking out. What's on for today? The level up system. Oh, Ramis, the level up system, buddy. How dare you attack me? Sorry, let me turn my phone off here, guys. Go away. Okay. Yeah, sorry, our level up system is what we're working on today. Everything's looking good, looking good. We got a gold sword. Oh, you know what? I'm gonna go fix something. We kind of hard coded something a while back and I haven't gone in and changed it. When we start a battle, when I go and build, oh, this can finally go away, right? We don't need this at all. Maybe I did fix a sissy. Give it a level. Oh, I know what I did. So we are loading all encounters, but what I changed in our encounters, we have encounter one. I made this a level two encounter. I'm going to go back and make this a level one encounter. And we will save it. So now when we run, we have a chance of hitting this our two different encounters. So we actually hit random one. Let's just make sure we're okay here. I need to give this guy a better weapon, not Rappy. Dark God needs a golden sword so we can kill people in one hit. Because killing people in one hit is what's important to us. So we're still getting random one. I just want to make sure that we hit encounter one at some point here. So I've ever written an ability system where leveling up an ability means a change in behavior instead of flat set upgrades. I haven't tried that yet, but about to soon wonder if each level up should actually be its own class and I should just face having to write them all. So Ramis, I have not specifically written an ability system like that, but I don't see that being too difficult. So I don't know if you've been following along with my ability system. Ramis is effects-based, right? In ability, if we pull up an ability here, like sleep, right? In ability, besides having all of this interesting stuff, is really just a series of effects. So this has one effect on it, has a sleep effect. But I could have a whole, we're going to have a whole library of effects eventually, right? So this could have multiple effects being applied to sleep. If I was to implement the way you want to do it in my ability system, I would just put a level attribute on my effects. And then I obviously we would level up abilities, not the heroes, or maybe both. But That way, depending on the level of ability, would tell you what effects would be applied to that ability. That's what I would do if I was going to go that route. Based on the system that I have implemented so far for us. Random. We still can't keep... Ah. Oh, God. That was so loud, everybody. I'm so sorry. Oh, wow. It's fixed. I fixed it. Okay, so... we hit random one again. Oh, you know what? I'm a moron, right? Did I not fix this encounter? I did. Let's try this again. I just want to make sure encounter one actually gets hit. Otherwise, we have a bug in randomly selecting. I don't think we do. We've hit encounter one in the past. So let me just run through a couple of combats. There we go. There's encounter one. And encounter one's pretty scary right now. Oh god, this thing looks hard. Looks difficult. Let's see, you wrote something like my effect system for a mobile game at work. It didn't scale too well when it grew large due to all the unforeseen interplay. Yes. Hard to manage. We're also inexperienced, so you might have written it superbly. Well, Rhymes, yeah, no, look, I might run into a similar problem as well. Right, when you start intermixing a lot of effects, you gotta be careful. And is that going to cause problems? I don't know yet. Because I haven't tried this effects-based system myself in the past either. So it's a little bit of a learning curve. Experimentation, right? That's how you learn. That's how we learn. Let me see. If I go to abilities, if I go to effects, in our base effect, we have a bit of a system in place. Right, where every effect has its own, can execute, we have pre-execution. So if I wanted to start having intermixing of effects, we would implement it in our engine runner here, right? When we execute each effect, we would potentially do intermixes. And maybe we'll start passing in, well, we know the owner, maybe we could start looking up the effects. Oh, I'm sorry, what I probably should start passing in is the ability, right? Because right now we don't pass in the ability. When we do this, we don't know what ability is being executed on this. Maybe I start passing in the ability so that we can look up other effects if we need to do a check for multiple effects happening. And if I do that, it's not so difficult, right? Because at that point, it's up to like the sleep effects or say the heal effect to do its own pre-execute past logic to know if other specific effects are being applied in the same ability at the same time. Yeah, so I might actually make that change before we get too far into our effects of passing in the ability. So, yeah. Hopefully I can buffer ourselves from that in the future. All right, so we were able to hit encounter one, which is a good thing. All right, what's our time at here? All right, 1 minute, guys, and we're going to jump in because I just want to make sure all my windows are open. Okay. Okay. Check this down here. Okay. Okay. That's good. And that is good. All right. Oh, you didn't have phases in your system, Ramses? You guys just, you had effect and you just executed effect. Yeah, that could be a pain, right? That could become a pain. Because in my system, even if you apply like a sleep effect to an ability, doesn't mean that sleep effect goes off every time, because a sleep effect can have its own pre-execute, it can have its own pass check. Right now, this is when it does pass, right? We don't implement it here because not every effect does, but for instance, like weapon damage effects. There's a can execute we override, which determines if this effect should execute. Whereas a power damage effect doesn't implement that because it can always execute. That's the difference we have between these two effects. If you want to attach a weapon damage effect, it'll do a hit check. A power damage effect, at least right now, doesn't have a hit check. It just does damage. Hey, Jalmega. What's up, man? What's up? Happy Pun Day. Okay, let's jump into it, guys. So this is what we're going to do, first of all. Let's get the UI updated quickly. I think we can do it pretty fast because we did it yesterday on these arrows. I want to put some back and forth arrows up here just so we can tab between all of our pain states because we have different pain states now. And to do that, we need to load the battle. I'm going to unload landing for a bit. And then in our hero pane, right, we have inventory panel, we have level panel, all this fun stuff. I want to, in the character UI, I'm going to turn this into an array of panels, right? This is of widgets. Turn this into an array. I'm sorry, I'm just thinking how I want to do the show hide of this. I think that's what I want to do. Yeah, okay, sorry. So in our character UI, I'm binding these specifically. That might be going away. If I actually did put these out of here, what would break right now? Make sure I'm not trying to use this stuff in weird places. So character UI, basically the show panel. Okay, perfect. That's okay. I can handle that. So what do I want to drag into here? I think we're going to have a base class, a base interface, so let's just implement that now. Character panel. So let's create an interface. Actually, not an interface. This is going to be a base class. We can still call it interface because it's still following that concept. I just want to implement it. So public class, iCharacter panel, or actually, can I implement this? Because it's kind of specific. Actually, nope. I'll show you why we're going to stick this with an interface, but I want to say public void display and public void hide. Sorry, get rid of public since it's an interface. So I can go to our equipment UI now and implement such a thing. Implement show and hide, display and hide. And in here, let's go back to, you can close down. Sorry, let me close some windows down. Battle mat I don't care about right now. We're going to keep you up because that's important. And there's our character eye. So when we need to show and hide things, right, show panel, this is the code that I want to grab. Take our transform, set it active. If the bag grid's null, refresh the bag, then start up a coroutine, and this will never be null. You're at you, okay. So that's our display, and then when we want to hide this thing, we just want to turn you off. Hide, set active to false. So there's display and hide for the equipment panel. Let's do the same thing for level panel now. And then for level panel, this was our show. which we just set ourselves active and call refresh and then hide. We're gonna say active is false, right? Perfect. So that's our display and hide. All right. Oh, and actually, no, this would be okay. This is perfect. This is perfect. So in character UI, I'm gonna get rid of all this code. Get rid of this code. This is gonna become generic now. I don't need this anymore. Let's go fix our bugs here. What do you mean battle mat can't be found? What did I do to the battle mat? It's namespace, but it's used like a type. Did I just do this in the UI? Character panel. I did not want to put a namespace in there. I wasn't paying attention because it's early in the morning. So I gotta fix these up. Very easy to do. Fix this one up. That should get us to compile. All right, there we go. I'm gonna close everything but this now. If I can, close it with this. There we go. All right, so I wanna create a public array, a public I character panel array of character panels. And let's see what this does to the hero panel up here. We should now get an array object that we can start dragging some stuff onto. And if this ever refreshes, did I not make it public? I did. It doesn't like it because it's a interface, huh? I think it doesn't like this because it's an interface. Because this is our character UI. It should have. All right, so we can make you a class of abstractness and then public abstract void. So instead of an interface, we might have to make it a full class, but it still acts kind of like an interface. You have to implement these. Oh, but then we can't do that because we have multiple. That's fine. So we'll have to go move mono behavior up to this level. Starting to get complex now, isn't it? And then move mono behavior out. You can only have one base class, right? We're talking about C#. Does not support multiple inheritance. That's why it has interfaces. But unfortunately, it looks like Unity does not like interfaces in its inspector UI. But we do. We do. Oh, this is a virtual. And these are still public. Oh, I'm sorry, why am I making a virtual? It's an override. Sorry, they're abstract. Overrides. And now thank you for the follow out there. I do appreciate it. Come down here, right? Make these overrides as well. And there we go. Now, will this do what I wanted to do? Who was that? Borat Matador. Thank you so much. Hope you're doing well out there this morning. Happy Pun Day, everybody. So there's our character panels now. Because what I want to do is take our level panel. Crap. And say our size is 2. I can't just drag it on there, I don't believe. And then now drag a level panel there. And in our inventory panel, gotta find the right script, which is there. Okay. Drag this onto there. Save everything. All right, so this will give us in an array, because we've done this already. So now from character UI, we can implement something like we did for cycle heroes. I'm actually gonna grab this function. And I wanna say cycle panel. And we'll say, you know, forward or backwards is cool. We know what the... We'll have a private variable up here for current panel. So we have current panel. If it's null, then we want to grab the first panel. We'll equal character panels of zero. Otherwise, find our index where we match, and then plus plus, if we're greater than our length, cycle back. Otherwise, we're going backwards, go to the end of the array. And these are never going to be not null. So from there, I can grab the current panel of IDX. And we can get this out of a while loop, because we don't need to do this while loop, right? Boom, there we go. And then from here, we can say, let's also capture previous panel. Var previous panel is equal to current panel. So first thing is, if previous panel is not null, hide it. And then current panel, show. Sorry, display, right? And actually, we can even make this simpler. I'm thinking about this in my head. We don't need to hide it there. What we could do is just get rid of here. If it's not null, then just say current panel, hide. And then after we get a new index, we'll display it. So that's how we cycle a panel. Show panel, because this wants to basically show the first panel, or whatever the active panel is. But we'll just say if not null, show display. This is basically if we're coming back in, if we're showing the UI for the first time. All right, let's add our buttons now. Public void next panel, and a public void previous panel. Both of these just gonna call cycle panel of true and cycle panel of false. This actually needs to be updated. That says if is null, we need to find I character panel of zero, use the first one, and then no matter what, character panels always display something. The BR, Apocapixel, how's it going? Are you asking if I am Brazilian? Is that what you're asking me? I am not, if that is the question, sir. Oh my god, thanks for the follows. Kang Tekken 1231. Welcome to the stream, man. Thanks for the follow. Alright, so cycle panel, previous panel, next panel. True, false, blah, 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 blah. All right, that's logic is what I want. We need to go bake in the UI for it now, like we did before. I think I'm actually just gonna copy this hero cycle panel and move it up into, let's see, into the hero panel itself so that I can drag it, and we'll resize and we'll do all that fun stuff. Why don't I have, hold on one second here, make sure I get my, what the heck happened? Where'd my buttons go? It didn't copy everything. Well, I mean it did, but let's reselect these. Oh, I gotta move them up. Sorry, this is weird. Where are they at? Guys, help me out. Where'd my buttons go? Where'd my icons at? Yeah. Oh, you think he's a Brazilian? Got it. Well, maybe. Sorry, I'm trying to figure out why my sprites aren't drawing. I would think this was a depth issue, but it's not a depth issue. It's enabled, right? We're enabled. What the hero data? These are fine. All right, what happens if I copy just that and paste that in? All right, guess we're gonna just reset these up. I'm just gonna reset them up. It's fine. We'll do it by hand, guys. We'll see what happens there. Here's cycle panel. Let's center this, size it properly. We'll make sure that our panels, if we display them, we don't want them to overlap. So this has to move down just a tad. Okay, make sure. What's this going to overlap? So that's the hero panel. There's equipment. There's the bag. Just want to make sure we're not overlapping anything. This is probably okay for now. Well, let's run it real quick and see. Because we should build our... Yeah, that'll be okay. I mean, it's just test interface until we get the real one in. Sometimes they get a little nitpicky. So turn you off now. Turn the level panel on. See if this is going to overlap a little bit. So we'll drag you down just a tad. Boop. Okay. And then that doesn't mess up anything. All right, good. So you can go off. Turn them off by default. All right, so cycle panel now. Let's create an empty object. This needs to be a sprite. Let's make sure the sprite can be displayed first, because that was having some problems last time. It's still not displaying. What in the world is going on? I don't know what's up. I don't know what's going on. Oh, there it is. So it is actually behind. But why won't it pop in front, right? So it's actually right here. It's drawing behind. Oh, is this on the wrong layer? Hold on. What layer should all this stuff be in? No, it should all be on the UI layer, right? Hero. Oh, it's not in the hero panel. That's our problem, guys. Wow. Why didn't anyone tell me that I didn't put this in the right place? So if that's the case, let's delete you. Let's grab these. Let's drag them as children here. Because I think I can get these to work now. Oh, actually, hold on. I'm going to delete the whole thing. Copy, paste, put it where it needs to be. Yeah, this is what I'm talking about. Yes, sirs. Okay. Make sure I'm not overlapping because I'm redoing this. Because he's going to get a little big up. Okay, so let's move these around now. Let's adjust their size. Kidoki, boop, boop, boop. So this one, same size, right? drag it over to here. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. Disable. Woo! What am I doing? I did not hear it. I am working on a quick UI element, my friend, so that we can then implement our level up system. Okay, so these are bound from a button standpoint to the wrong places. We got to go fix them, right? So instead of the hero, actually it is the hero panel, just not on previous hero. This is previous panel. And this will be next panel. And let's rename these. Previous panel. Call this next panel. The question is, will this work? Let's find out. Let's load the right scene, unload that scene. Let's hit play and see what's up. Load a game. Hit inventory. Ha 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 ha! So we're able to cycle between our panels now, right? What's this? Let's go check this level panel, line 27. Table's null, huh? That is a possibility. So we'll just say if table is null, you'll break. Wow. Isn't it nice when Unity crashes on you guys? Isn't that always a good day? That's why we always save our scene after we make a change. Always save your scene. Alrighty. Otherwise, you will lose any of your changes. Never hit play until you saved your scene. Alright, so this is still showing good. This is good. That's Rappy, right? There's Dargon. This refreshes as it should. This refreshes. If I keep up this, hit close in inventory, that should store. That should store. Alright. Alright, everybody. So that's what I wanted to do, right? Now I can go make changes to our leveling system. So awesome. It's so amazingly awesome. I'm out of coffee all of a sudden. Out of coffee. Let's open up something else to drink. Let's change things around a bit here. Okay, so let's make sure we commit this. Our character UI, stage and commit, yay. All right, so now we have to go make some changes because here's how our system works at the moment, guys. And we'll look at it from a character editor standpoint and move our way up there. Let's look at Dargon, right? Dargon has abilities. Right now, Dargon has just a basic ability. If we were to open up abilities as well, we'd see that basic attack is learnable. It doesn't have a learn cost because you get it for free at the start of the game and doesn't have anything else. Now let's look at sleep. Sleep is also learnable. This is now going to have a learn cost, right? So let's just fix sleep right now. So sleep has a learn cost. So that means you're not going to have this at the beginning of the game, and it's going to cost you some points to learn this. Do not drink much coffee. It's bad for health. Coffee is not bad for your health, guys. Why would you think that coffee is bad for your health? Like anything else, it is just fine in moderation. Anything in excess is bad, but coffee's okay. We have this sleep ability, right? So Now if we add the sleep ability to our Dargon and we save it, and he has the sleep ability, and now let's play the game. Hopefully I didn't break anything here. And we look at Dargon. You'll see that... Sorry, let me do something here. What did I break? Kill you. When it comes to Dargon's turn, which will be right now, after all these guys, give it a moment. Give it a moment. All right, so Dargon has the sleep ability. Is that because of his inventory? Let me check. It is. Let me get rid of our... this shield gives you the sleep ability. All right, so you can see that Dargon now only has the basic attack ability. Even if we look at his hero, he has... the sleep ability is attached to this character, right? But because it has a learn cost, he doesn't know it right now. And if we go to our inventory and we pull up... I'm actually going to change this. It's not going to be inventory more. This is going to be, you know, just character or whatever. If we look here at Dargon... we actually don't show... why don't I show that? We should be showing... let me take a look at that real quick. So in our level panel, when we refresh, we just look for can learn abilities. Oops. Let's take a little looky through. Let's attach a profiler. I don't want to attach a profiler. Proven health problems. Yeah, but there are health, but well, there are little health benefits to caffeine. Because of coffee? What? Intensive care because of coffee? What did you, consume a lot of caffeine all at one time? Like, anything in excess is bad. Of course anything in excess is bad. Okay, so this should refresh us. We look at our... oh, we don't even have this as an ability. That's right. So we have to go back into our system now. So when we go to our abilities, when we build the character... oh, this is right. This is character is saved in our save file. We have to... these are supposed to be abilities that you've already learned. These are supposed to be the abilities that you've already learned. These are the abilities that we know. And that is fine. So I'm actually doing this wrong. So I should not look at our actor abilities. I should go to character data abilities and look at the can learn abilities from there. That'll fix that bug. I was just showing the abilities that we have already learned instead of the abilities that we can learn. Load game. If we go to inventory now, so now if we look at Dargon... get rid of his shield. We'll see that. We'll see that he now has right base attack and sleep, but we don't know sleep yet. I want to... we need to put something here to let them know if they've learned it yet or not, because I kind of want to put a kind of a grayed out color if they don't know it. And we have the ability to do that, right? We created that in the UI. Ability icon, there's disable ability and enable ability, and enable is done by default. I wonder if I need to wait before... I need to put, private bool enabled is true, because I got it wired up for start as well. So enable true, enable false. 9 cups a day, that's if not in 12 hours, that's pretty good, buddy. Too much bananas, you can't eat enough of them. okay. So then if enabled, if we were previously enabled, before start gets called, otherwise disable the ability. That'll fix that. So now we can call, we can figure out if this is right. So we've gone through all of our learnable abilities. Let's see if we know this ability. Var learned, instead of var, let's make it bool, learned. Is equal to actor abilities, where E equals our ability, and then gets a count greater than zero. So this will tell us if we know this or not, and then if not learned, because by default we enabled the icon, disable the ability. Let's see what that does. Okay, let's run this now. So if we look at, should I go to dark on, drop that off, for what is that gone? What am I doing here? Hold on. Oh, the hover sprite gets disabled, and we do a half color, which is good. Maybe I don't want to disable the hover sprites. I don't think I want to mess with that. Let's see what that does. And then we'll look at it from the inspector here, if that's still not correct. All right, let's load Dargon. Get rid of you. And I actually got to fix something else as well in there. Okay, so there's sleep. And, oh, are we drawing on, where is basic attack? So we're going to look at it in the panel now. So let's look at our level panel, our ability table. So I think they're both on top of each other, is what it looks like. So there's sleep. There's basic attack, right? And if we're moving one of them off, why are they drawing on top of each other? Why is it doing that? Which it should not be doing that, but obviously you can see that this is grayed out now, right? Compared to you. But why? Is that happening? It's because we have an old reference in here, I think. Ability icon line 43. So we're not getting where we need to go. Oh, the sprite has not bound yet. Because this is in start. Okay, so we'll set this if sprites is null return. This is fine. This will be okay. This will set our flag. If sprite's not set up, that means we haven't called start yet, but then on start, we'll recheck the flag and we'll recall this. Okay. I think that was our big problem. So that, we weren't reordering the table because we were having, our coroutine was exiting early. I want a banana right now. Hey, somebody send me a banana. There we go, right? So let's go to Dargon. Get rid of your shield. Now let's go to here. There we go. Basic attack. And this is disabled, and we can make it more grayed out to really show it. But this is enabled, right? So this is good. And I want to always keep the hover on here. And then from here, once you click, we're going to have an on click, which will keep the hover active. And let us learn that. All right, so I need to make another fix, though. So we're getting there. This is not complete. I need to also check if e dot is learn. Not yet. Can learn. So if it's the ability and it's a learnable ability, have we learned it? If we have not, make sure it's disabled for now. And that's that. All right. Let's go back to the UI and bind up a click event so that we can keep it highlighted when we click on it. Okay, so level pain. That's when I get to an ability icon. And hover is where our button is. So on pressed, what do we do with when we click it? So we have a hover state. We have a pressed state, which looks okay. Right, that's one. There's hover. I think I'm gonna copy this color for pressed. Boop. We'll keep the same icon. We just need an on click. Now, actually, do we need an on click? Well, actually, I do want an on click because right now everything is bound to hover. Yeah, so I'm thinking for a moment here. So I have a hover. So if we look at our UI, we have ability icon hover. I think I'm going to do the same thing for here. Yeah. We'll do another pass through. Serializable, public class click event, which is a Unity event, which takes no parameters in. Okay, so from a click event, I just want to make sure it doesn't leave unless it changes. I was just thinking in my head, how am I going to implement this, which we'll get to. So now I have a public click event, click, and then void on click. Is it on click or on press? We'll find out if click. Not equal to null, click dot invoke. That'll do that. So now we should get, once this recompiles, new icon down there. Let's do a public void on click. So right now we call hoverability is over or not over. I need a pass through, so we want to call panel lock ability of ourself. Yeah, let's implement that. Okay, let's go there. Ability icon. So now we need to cache the icon that's locked. So private lock ability is null by default. This is, so when we lock an ability, ability icon will lock it. And then on hover, if ability is not null, we'll hover over, that's fine. Otherwise, in the else, if there is a lock ability, or actually we'll do this. If ability is not null, if ability is not null, think of this, that's fine. If lock ability is not null, else display nothing, and then grab you, this will be okay. And just use the lock ability. So now, how do we unlock? Ability, should ability. Oh, this should be a base ability that I need to lock. Not an ability icon, of course. Base ability. All right, so this will let us lock the ability. So if I click lock ability again, we'll say this. If lock ability equals ability, let's just call this ability now. Okay. If it's the same, we'll unset it, right? We'll toggle it. Otherwise, set it. And in here, we want to pass ability, not null. So that's the on click. I can wire this up now. So let's add as an object, we want to bring the ability icon in here. And then on ability icon, there should be an on click. All right, let's apply this. I need to test this now. So let's unload. And while that's locking in, let's get a breakpoint here and let's put a breakpoint here. Make sure that the binding worked. And we'll see if we can lock an ability by clicking on it. So that from the hover standpoint, that's what I'm basically trying to do. Go away. Okay, so if we click there, on click, find base, M calls, that's not good. That's not good at all. Or is it? Oh, actually it is okay. I guess it just wasn't showing me the binding. So now you can see that sleep. Oh, we need to keep the hover. Why is the click going away? Do I need to unbind the hover off? Oops. I want to keep the hover tween on. But you notice here that sleep is there. And of course, if I basic attack, but now we go back to sleep. And if I click it again, that will unlock it. Or it should unlock it. Not unlocking it. So let's see. Lock ability. Click. Okay, so we set that to null. And then if ability is null, why is the lock ability? Oh, that's coming up to the panel, but I thought we just nulled this out. Oh, crap, I'm a moron. Detach, sorry guys. Else, we were falling through and we were always setting that. So that'll unlock us now. But why are we losing the hover target? Obviously it's something to do with the tween and the UI or the NGUI button. Let's look at this. Stop. Level pane. Let's take a look at you. So that's not the button, right? So this is actually the button is our hover. So we have transition states. I wonder if I should just, if there's a way for me to disable the tween target of the UI button. Maybe that's all I gotta do. Because we have a pressed state, right? Or, because what's happening is we're going back to the normal state. After I press it, I wanna stay in the pressed state. Because we're going back to the normal state, essentially, was what happening here. I wonder if we can just turn off, if I can unset the tween target and it won't touch anything. That would be cool. Let's find out. So an ability hover icons on click. Just going to fall through. So we know the level panel here. If... but I don't pass. I might have to also pass. I think I'm also gonna pass the UI button as the owner. Let's do that. So in the hover icon, and I wanna pass this through, sorry. So this is now gonna pass in a UI button. And I want to pass, so we're in the hover icon, so if click var button is equal to get components, UI button, and then invoke on that, okay. And then when we get the on click UI, this will take the button of the owner, right, button owner, and we pass that through. Make sure all that compiles. I might have to rebind this. Waiting. Yep, so that's what I thought was gonna happen, which is okay. On click of UI button now. And then it, what UI button should it pass with it? Well, we're gonna set it. Oh, hold on. We're gonna set it. But that's the click. That's fine. So we'll just take our hover and pass that in there. I think that'll be okay. Let's apply that. All right. So what are we gonna do now in the level panel? Now that we have the owner. This is if we're gonna lock. So if we can say this.tween target. And what's our normal tween target? Is ourself, right? So we wanna say tween target is null. When we unlock, set the tween target back to owner dot game object. I don't know. I don't know. We're gonna find out. Wish me luck, guys. Wish me luck. I'm hoping this does what I want to. Otherwise, we gotta look into the UI button code to see how it operates. So let's get the dark on. Remove you. Okay. Let's expand everything so we can see it work in real time. Right, so there's the hover, there's the tween target. If we come in here and we click it, it lost the tween target and it's stuck. Oh my God, that's perfect, guys. That's perfect. That's what I wanted to happen, right? Keep the highlight on there because we know now. Let's see if this works. Boom, click it. And we move away, and it goes, oh, that's so good. That's so good. Can't believe that worked. It just worked. It worked perfectly, too. All right, what's this here? Icon 21. If ability, so at start, we don't have an ability. That's not good. Why would we not have an ability bound at start time? And that just happened once. Let's see if we can duplicate this. Close. Well, I want to see if this happens again. Because this might be, oh, you know what this is? I know what this is. That's fine. So I'm just going to do this. If is null, just return. It's our, we have a default ability icon added to the table so that, you know, from an edit perspective, if I need to edit the prefab, I can just do it right in the scene. But that gets deleted and it gets replaced. It doesn't have an ability associated with it. So this is, that will fix our null reference. I made my own button event. Oh, I didn't make my own button event. I mean, I guess I kind of made my own button event to a degree. Yeah, I guess so. Diva, all right, so. Good. Let's just double check that. Make sure our exception goes away. 8-bit UI coding adventure. I know, right, man? What's up, buddy? So now we can click. It's going to stay, right? We're locked on here. Obviously, if you hover over a different ability, we'll show that for comparison. But that way it locks so that when I come down here, we can click learn, right? So it's locked and then we can learn it. It's locked. We can learn it if we need to, et cetera, et cetera. Uh-oh. Let me check something. So, aha, bug. In our level panel, when we set the tween target, when we unlock an ability, we're unlocking owner tween target ability, right? That's bad. I need to unlock the owner. I need to reset the tween target of the old locked ability. So I need to cache this as well. So private UI button locked owner. So when we do lock owner, just make sure we cache it. So I can say locked owner dot tween target is equal to locked owner game object. And then we'll null it out as well, unlock everything. That'll fix that bug. Because what was happening was, am I still playing? Right, I can lock this. Now, of course, we are recompiled, so we're all messed up. But we should be fixed now. I was able to lock each button, which was not a good thing to do. just from that hover icon. So now for locked, if I click here, that should have unlocked. It should have unlocked, right? So let's go back. All right, so everything's unlocked. We've locked. We can still hover. If I lock you, that should have taken its hover away. Now if I click it and click it, right, it'll go away. So what did I not do? If locked ability, if it's the same ability. Oh, this is okay, this works fine. Otherwise, in the else, if locked ability is not null, or say if locked owner is not null, that means we're trying to toggle the lock to a different one. Run this code, and now we're gonna get a new lock donor, right? That'll fix it. Why don't I use the default Unity button component, Apocalypto? We don't use the default, we're not using the Unity UI in game, we use NGUI. We use a different UI framework. Okay, so now I can lock it, and it's actually working, sort of. It's sort of working. We need to force the tween on it. So if you notice here, I click this button, we lock it, right? I click this. This locked here. That's now unlocked, but the script hasn't run to hover, right? So if I was to come over here, and now it'd be fixed. So we just need to force the hover on it. We need to force the hover on it, locked owner. We might have to go look at the code for how it does hover and unhover. And there's an on click. But I don't want to call on click. Well, no. We could force the tween. Yeah, so let's go take a look at UI button. We have the source code for it. We can call on enable. If the application's not playing, that's fine. So if we are enabled, if init is done, we could also say just on hover, which calls, if we're hovering over, we could force this to be true always. Let's see, on hover, go to implementation, which is just gonna do a tween target set state. So there we go. So we can actually do a set state then, if this is, that's protected. We might have to expose this on our button. Go to implementation for the UI button. It has a public override. So we can actually call set state, and we can set the state to normal instead of hovered. That's all we wanna do. Okay, so perfect. After we reset the tween target set state to normal and true to make it immediate. Now, let's see if that works. Okay, load a game. Inventory. Let's lock you. Right, so now we can lock back and forth. And it will unset it immediately. Boom, boom, boom. That's perfect. That's perfect, guys. Excelente. Let me make sure I check all this in. Adding click states to ability icons. Commit early and often. Early and often. Do it. Make it so engaged. All right, next phase of what we need to do is apply our points. We need to make sure we back them up. Okay, so if we go to our battle component, and within our battle component, we have battle stats. Do I want to put this on battle stats? I kind of do. So in battle stats, we have a bunch of base stats, right? We have our main stats, we have derived stats, HP, SP. We have our level, we have experience, blah, blah, blah. I'm gonna put it down here. Right now I have a public int learn points, which is a getter setter. So we're just gonna have learn points. I need to go to the game system now where we save a hero. Do I have to recompile? I do. This is a new field. So we're gonna, this will be interesting. We haven't messed with this in a while, right? So file, open, file. I thought I had, is it, hold on. Is it part of scripts? Thought it was part of here, but I think it got removed. It's fine. File, open, file. In our IDL, we got to go update what serialization system are we using again, guys? I forgot the name of our serialization system. We'll look it up in a moment. But we have to adjust this because we save name, level, HP, SP. We have to add a new field here. And remember, we can add, we have an existing save file. This is not going to break our existing save files as long as we add to the end of tables. So this is now going to be an LP of a UINT. And we have a compiler for that. So that's all I needed to do from a hero so we can save that. Let's go to raw, flack, right? Run this. We have a new compiled code. Which is our game data. Flat buffers is what we have. And if we look at hero now, we should have LP down at the bottom. So now we can go to our save system where we write a hero. And at the very, very end, before we end a hero, save system, hero, add LP. And this is gonna be hero stats LP. So that will now save LP. Is a UINT. And when we load a hero, just reverse that. Just checking, right? We're going through ability. Hero in this case is a save hero. There it is. Okay, good. So bcstats.lp is equal to hero dot. Get L.LP. Hey, Faith. Hey, Amarin. How's it going, guys? Save up all your commits to push on Friday at basically 5 p.m. Yeah, let's do that. That's what I want to do. Cast it back to him. In games, fine. All right, so this will save and load LP. Just to validate, we can try and load our old game. And as you can see, our save file worked, even though we added a brand new property to our hero. And the code is trying to load LP from the save file for each hero. Flat buffers is good enough that it's forward and backwards compatible. So it's gonna say that, oh, LP was never saved, so it'll give you a default value for LP, which of course is gonna be zero right now. But at least, we didn't break our save file for adding a new property. You can add some code here. We can add some code here that says, hey, LP should never be zero, rebuild LP, or whatever you wanna do. Or have a property that says, hey, what version is this, blah, blah, blah. So there, obviously in code, you can do adjustments here. If you're adding a new property in the middle of your game, people have save files or halfway through the game and you're adding something new to the save, you're not gonna break all those old save files. And there's a lot of games out there that have that problem. I'm sure if you guys have ever played an early alpha for a game, or maybe not even early alpha, maybe in a beta for a game, and all of a sudden you see that big update that comes, that says game version 0.8 is going to 0.9, all old save files are invalid because they had to adjust their save file format. and they had no way of merging or using the old save system. Bad things. Make sure your save files or any serialization you do is good. Make sure it's safe. Okay, so we have an LP now. Sorry, get off my soapbox. We have LP. I want to show how many learn points we have in the UI. So let's load scene. Basically, I want to drop it somewhere here. Hero panel, level panel, right? So there's our leveling panel. Our table, we're basically going to fill up everything here. I wonder if I should just put it down in our ability description area. Name, text, right? We have a learn button. I think I'm just going to drop it down there for now. So I'm just going to grab you, put you here. This is going to be LP colon space for now. We're going to resize you. That's not the resize I wanted to do. I want to drag you. Come on, let's get dragging. Holy cow. Let's try that. Okay, apparently I have to make it big for a bit just so I can line it up. So we have our learn button. All of a sudden my learn button is missing. Bring you back. And then bring you forward. Okay, better. I think this would be okay down here. LP. Crap. Stop doing that on me. So we're just gonna show LP to the right of our button. So I need to bind this up into the level UI on our level panel. Let's add a new public UI label of LP. Give this a moment, it should come on up. Or if you have a version number in your file and an update breaks the save, then you convert it to the new save system. Yeah, you could do that as well, but then you have to write a bunch of code that says, okay, and it depends on how your serialization system works, right? Because if your serialization system can't support that version number checking early on, you're in trouble. Because what you'd have to do is you have to read the save file just enough to say, oh, what's the version of this save, so that I can know what legacy load method I can use to load it up, fix it, and then resave it in the new format, which then also means you have to keep all of your load methods, right? So if you had, you have to almost keep version one of your save file, the entire deserialization process as a set of methods. And then when you get to version 1.1 of your save file, you now need a 1.1 version, right? It can get very, very confusing very quickly, depending on how you're laying out your serialization system. So just be careful with that stuff. You just want to be careful with it. Okay, so we have an LP. Drag that in, save that. From a code standpoint, at refresh time, we'll do it in refresh time. LP.text, I have our actor, right? We have actor, okay, good. LP.text is equal to actor stats LP to string. Okay. Stop. I don't want to actually run you yet. Gotta unload this. Okay. Okie dokie. Just to check, right? LP0, perfect. And they both should have LP0 right now. because that's just what happens. Level one. We're not level two or anything yet. Let's actually make sure we apply when we do level up. So character data handles leveling up. So when we level someone up, I want to say actor stats LP plus equal to 2. To do replace with proper LB progression. Right now we're just going to give you 2 learn points every level until we figure out what the LP system actually is. If you don't want to have that code inside your game, you can give it an external update tool for this. Yeah, you can, but it's just so terrible. It becomes a pain in the ass, right? All right, so now we're going to gain LP. Actually, I want to just do a check here. We shouldn't just do this, because we actually call level up for level 1. So if the progression dot min level not equal to 1 and max level not equal to 1, we don't want to give you learn points at level 1. It's because that's basically the start of the game. You have to level up to get that. All right, so that'll give us some LP. When do we call level up? Character data, we just level you up. That's basically to give you your first level. We don't have the system in place right now to actually level up. What we do, it's just in here, we reapply your experience and we basically, this is not good, guys. I gotta change our system. I think instead of storing your level, all right, this is all we gotta do. Now this will be fine. We'll have a bool apply LP, which by default is false. So if apply LP and all the rest of that, so we can just do this then. So we'll have 2 ways to level up where we skip LP setting. So if we apply LP, good, replace with, that's fine. Yeah, that's good. So we can now from our level up of creating a new hero, we don't apply level P. So right now we don't have anything that applies LP. I mean, call level up, which is okay. We're going to be adding that at the end of combat very shortly. The learn button. Learn. Level panel. And this, I want to go implementation. I'm actually going to add a public bool has learned. Because we're going to start calling this in a lot of places, ability. So I just want to add a quick check. Have we already learned this ability? If, let's say, var learned is equal to abilities where E equals ability counts is greater than 0, and then just return learned. Make our life a little easier here, because now I can just say learned is equal to actor has learned the ability. Okay. Because on the clip, right, when I lock an ability, or actually we'll do it on the hover. Yeah, I think it's gonna have to be on the hover. Equals, I don't have actor anymore, do I? Just gotta grab it. If actor has learned the ability, if learned, I have the button here, right? Do I have our button? Public UI button. UI button. Learn button. We'll bind that. Back to what I was doing. So if we've learned, learn dot enable of true. No, I'm sorry, false, right? Actually, let's just do the inverse. Enable is the inverse of learn. So if we have not learned it, we want to enable the learn button. We're going to do another check here, but for now, this get us started. We want to do the same thing in here. On the locked ability. See what that does. Okay. Almost want to fight combat just to save our file here to get rid of these, but that's okay. So if we look at abilities now, that's not good, but probably because of here, 96. Oh, because I'm not... Off the cliff we go. All right, let's load. We forgot to bind our button, guys, in our level panel. So we have a learn button here, and there's our learn button, which is not added. Add our learn button. Save. Unload. Yeah. Okay. Alright, so now this is disabled. We're probably going to give a better disabled state here, which we can do. And then here, that's enabled, right? So now it's enabled, disabled. Even though we don't have a good disabled state, we're going to go fix that right now. And then we'll do our next piece. Level panel. Go to our learn button. Actually, there is a disabled. Oh, am I not setting the state? I probably need to set the disabled state as well. So learn.setState disabled if. Okay, so based off of learn, if we have learned, we will normal state it. Otherwise, button color state disabled, right? And then true for immediate. Okay. And then while I'm here, let's test this first because I'm about to break. I didn't want to do that. I'm about to break that whole button up because we don't have any learn points. But that'll be our next check. Okay, so this is what I'm going to do real quick, guys. I'm going to do this. I'm going to close this. This is going to be a pain, but that's fine. Let me win this fight, because at the end of every combat, we save the game. We do an auto save at the end of every combat. And actually, one more thing, Dargon. Make sure they both, okay, good. So I just want to do that. I want to get rid of that shield, because that shield right now is adding a sleep ability, which I don't want it to be there for these guys. For testing purposes. Thanks for the follow out there, by the way. Oh, minimalist gamer. What's up, buddy? Welcome to the stream, man. Welcome to the stream. Okay, by the way, guys, I'm going to be mentioning it a few times just so everyone who's here or who's not here over the next couple weeks gets the memo. Also put on Twitter and Twitch, of course. So we saved. That's fine. I'm just going to stop. I want to start. Just want to double check that we don't have these shields attached anymore. Next month, March, first weekend of March, I will not be streaming. I'm judging a hackathon. At a university here, which means, and it starts, of course, Saturday morning and goes to the end of Sunday. So I will be able to stream Saturday, so I'll probably try and do a Friday evening stream. But just letting you guys know. Damn it, why did Rappy get hit this armor back? Do we try to equip something immediately? That might be possible. That's fine. Dargon doesn't have it, which is what I care about. Oops. Okay, so learn button is not. Oh, it's getting the inverse, by the way, guys. It is getting the inverse of what I wanted it to be. So set state if learned, if we have learned it, right? If we have learned, set it normal. Oh, that's right. If we've learned it, we want to be disabled. Otherwise, we want to be normal. So that, fine. And then also stop load. I want to set the default state on this stupid button. If I can, otherwise we'll do it in code. But I would like to do it from the button itself. UI button, it doesn't have a default state, does it? That would be nice. That'd be nice if it just had a state dropdown here. It says, hey, what's the default state that you want to use? Okay, well, you have failed me. This failed me, guys. We'll just do it during refresh. Yeah, we'll do it during refresh. So, learn dot set state disable true. Right. Easy to fix. Just stream the hackathon null. I might, maybe, possibly. There might be a little of that. Periscope it. Oh, God. That's not my neck of the woods anymore, Amarin. But it is my old neck of the woods. That's right. Client wants me there Monday through Friday each week through the first week of March. Where in California? Oh, Laguna Beach. Laguna Beach, man. That'll be good. You'll have some fun there. Traffic sucks in Laguna Beach, Amarin, FYI, just so you know, unless you're staying close to the site that you're going to be working at. First of all, you're going to have to pay tolls to get in and out of Laguna Beach. So make sure you charge that on your expense report. But Laguna Beach is good. Hopefully the weather's not too bad when you're out there. All right, so let's bind up this button now. Let's actually do the learn. Oh, sorry. The last thing I want to do for the has learned is fine. If not learned. And can we afford this ability now, right? So we haven't learned it. Ability, let's see, cost. Has a learn cost is less than our actor stats LP. Actually, we'll say if it's greater than. Learned is equal to. Basically, you just want to say, oh, you cannot learn this, right? So we'll fake this and say that it is learned. So if you can't, if you have not learned it, but you can't afford to learn it, we're going to just say that, okay. Well, for our logic, let's assume you have learned it, so just that we can enable the button, right? We just want to disable or enable the button based off of that statistics. And let me, one more thing here, disable the state. When we hover away and we're resetting everything, let's disable our button. All right, now we can bind up the learn button. Okay, so here's our level panel. Learn button does not have a click right now. We're gonna add it to here. Public void on learn. Make sure that saves and builds so that we can use it. Let's drag our level panel. Level panel on learn. So there's our on click for the learn button. When we learn this, that means we can afford it, right? This button won't be enabled unless we can't, we haven't learned it and we can't afford it. So we don't have to do those checks again. Let's just learn the ability. And we have it cached because it's our locked. It's going to be the locked ability. So to learn this, we'll say var cost is the learn cost. Let's get the actor. Actor stats LP minus equal to cost. Yeah, we should be good there. And then we'll say actor.abilities. We want to add an ability, which is the lock ability. So we'll add that. And then I think I just want to call refresh. After we've learned the ability, should we just refresh everything? I think I want to just refresh. So first of all, we should not be able to learn the sleep ability because we don't have the correct number of points. And we're going to validate that. So let's unload. Let's see it. Really, good morning, Rick. How you doing, man? Sorry, I was not scrolling in chat there, and I missed a little step. Yeah, happy Super Bowl Sunday. Who you rooting for, Rick? What's your team? As a non-American, don't really care about the Super Bowl. You don't have to be American to care about the Super Bowl. It's a professional championship sporting event. Just watch to have fun. You have a hackathon coming up in Scotland. Back of Orange, do you know what the theme of your hackathon is? Watching TV commercials are pretty good, Rick. That's hilarious. You guys. Let's load this up. Check inventory for Dargon, just making sure. Okay. So now, if learn is disabled, when we hover over, right, we can't learn basic attack because we already know it. And we'll probably, because this is highlighted, right? For sleep, we can't learn sleep either because we don't have any LP. So I'm going to go fix this by hacking our save system. When we load a hero, I'm going to override BC. Stats LP is going to be equal to 2. We're going to just give all of our heroes 2 LP for testing purposes. I think they're going to pull it out. Matt, yeah. We'll see what happens, Rick. We'll see what happens. But more than likely, very true. Okay, so Dargon, we have 2 LP now, right? So when we swap our heroes, right, we have 2 LP. We know this, which is fine, but now you can see that we can actually learn sleep. Oh, I should put the cost. We'll put the cost in here somewhere as well. Let's see if I'm doing this right. So if I hover over here, I can't learn, which is fine because we know it. And this we can learn. Uh-oh. Whoop, whoop. What just happened here? I think if you go too quick here, I have a bug. We'll fix that bug. Because if I hover over here and we move down, this is getting not set correctly. That's an easy fix, but okay. Let's see what happens when we learn this. Will we learn this ability? We used one LP. Thumbs up, guys. We used one LP. This now got enabled, right? It's not grayed out anymore. It's full color. But we can't learn it anymore, and we can't learn it anymore, and now we only have one LP. What's this? Batted level pain 110. If actor, do you think we don't have an actor? This is when we hover an ability. We might not have an ability. Oh, but no, we should be using the locked ability here. Sorry, guys. Wait, what ability is this? Yeah, I'm sorry. I should be using the locked ability. That was the bug. For that, that's fine. No problemo. But we've learned this, and if we close now, and we can't do anything because we hit this exception, so we got to redo this. We got to just redo it and test it again. Factory. All right, man. Have fun. Enjoy your day. Stay out of too much trouble. Dargon, let's look at Dargon. So, we know this, we can learn this, this big, yeah, so this got fixed, right? We fixed this, which was good. Boop, 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 boop. We fixed it, let's learn sleep. Boom, we know sleep now, because we're awesome like that. So if we, oh crap, still trying to access it. Where was this coming from? We're trying to send it. Oh, because when we click. Oh, I know how we'll fix that. I'll show you how we fix that. But hopefully this doesn't break anything. The problem is in on learn, right? Which is a click event. We're calling refresh, which is causing the UI to destroy our object that we are in a click event for, which can't happen. So I will not call refresh. We'll just update our locked icon because we have the icon. We can just set the state. Now that we have, I know, right? But so let's kill someone here. We're so powerful, Rad. It's so, hey, Private Cake. So now, as you can see, we have basic attack and we have sleep. Let's actually put this guy to sleep. Wah, wah, wah. Wah, wah. And there we go. Okay. And actually, Rappy can learn sleep as well. Right? Because Rappy is the rappiest and Dargon the Dargoniest. It's Dargon the Dragon and Rappy the Rappiest is what we've learned. Let's go fix this bug here. So instead of calling refresh, all we really have to do, right? We have the locked owner. We have code that does this already, which is in the unlock. What do we want to set? Actually, I just want to call icon. I need to get the ability icon. So from the locked owner, yeah, I can do this. So get component in parent, which is our ability icon. Enable our ability. That's really all we need to do. Let's test that. Boop, 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 boop. Okay, inventory. Let's just do it for Rappy, right? So he knows this, he does not know sleep. If we learn it, instantly goes highlighted, and we are good. And, oh, did the button instantly go away? Did we disable the button right away? Let's find out. So as soon as we learn, uh-oh, what just happened here? Good, okay. So as soon as we learn, I think that's a bug, right? So if I have you, and we flip over here and we click, and then we flip back. No, okay. I was just confusing myself. All right. We are gonna learn. This is still enabled. We actually need to also disable our learn button, right? Oh, and we need to update LP. So we have to do a little bit of a mini refresh, which is okay. Grab LP. and we'll just do this. A little bit of a mini refresh. Okie dokie. Okay. Load this up. Alright, so now when we learn, this should instantly refresh. Our learn button should go to a disabled state, which it does. Perfect. And perfecto. Let's go to our next hero. Click you. Ah, see, that's a problem. Oh, it's the same ability. No problemo. No problemo. Locked ability. When we show... Where are you at? On display... So when we display, I want to make sure I unset this. Locked owner. Actually, if locked owner is not null, locked owner tween target is equal to game object. Reset the tween target, and then we'll null it out no matter what when we display, right? Well, actually, we should do this in hide. Let's do this in the proper place. So before we unactivate, we need to do just a little bit of cleanup. A little bit of cleanup, because the abilities are kind of shared objects between people. So if two people can learn the sleep ability, we're having trouble there. I was thinking it was already clicked. So if I go here, right, we learn it. Everything is good. Well, not so good. This should be disabled now. Like that. We'll have to look at that issue. But see how I have sleep selected? And if we go to Rappy... And I select sleep, now we're good. Before it was like, I don't know what to do. You already have this selected, now I'm trying to unclick it. We'll learn here. Yeah, so we're not disabling. And obviously, oh, the button is still enabled, isn't it? One other thing I gotta do. Well, we do set the disabled state, but also need to say learn.enabled is false. Yeah, learn dot, we're not setting it to false. Try that. Make sure that gets fixed, everybody. Everybody! So this is disabled now, but we're not putting it into the disabled state, which I'm telling it to do. I wonder if to implementation. Sprite's not null. Switch disabled. Set sprite to the disabled sprite. UI sprite 2D. No, we should use UI sprites. And then we break. What does set sprite do? All we do is set the sprite name. So this is not instantly refreshing. That's fine. All right. So what I... To fix this... Private void not void. I gotta make this into a coroutine. So we're gonna coroutine the whole thing up, and here's just gonna be a start coroutine of onLearn. And then after we disable it, I wanna do a yield return new wait for end of frame. And then we'll disable, and then we'll be okay. Hey, Preston, what's up, man? Ah, hit exit. Okay, let's try it. Let's try this. Okay, good. Now when we learn it, damn you. Damn you! Why is that not doing what I wanted to do? So we're in the click state. Boop. Oops, sorry. Oh, now this is back. That's back. UI button has been destroyed. What is it talking about? Clear everything here. What has been destroyed and why can't I hover? This is saying in R. Notify block ability. The object of type has been destroyed. So we're trying to click and lock an ability, but it's saying that this object no longer exists, which is just false. Which is not true at all. Let's see, so that's an on learn. Did this change anything when we click on learn? Yeah, nothing should be changing here. So yield, return, new, wait for seconds. I'm just gonna do a little check here. See what happens after 3 seconds. Cause I don't know why, but our disabled state is not kicking off when I want it to. Then a week I have to take, pass my A+ last week studying for the network. Oh, nice, man, congrats. Congratulations. All right, so if we learn this, boom. Okay, now, but see how it goes disabled. As soon as we mouse off of it, it still wants to handle some things. Or maybe I didn't wait the full amount of time. So we're disabled. Here's the other bug that I want to look at, because this causes a refresh to happen. And boom, instantly messing things up. So when I call lock ability, we pass the owner. I wonder if it's the binding of... I think I need to dynamically bind owner. I thought I was dynamically binding owner. Okay, hold on. Hold the phone. There's our hover, right? So, and it's actually, it's not the click, it's on hover. Was it on hover? So it's actually, no, it's ability icon on click. When we call lock ability. So let's put a breakpoint, debug, attach. You go away. Let's try that again. It's always fun solving bugs. Right. So that click is good. We're going to get component on ourselves. Of our button, which should be fun. This is okay, right? We learn, we're good, yay. When I flip over to another hero, so button, let's see if it's destroyed. How do I check if it's destroyed? We gotta get all the way to the base, right? Enabled is true. Non-public, okay. The transform, I thought there's something in here that'll tell if it's destroyed or not. Which so far, that's a big no. And that's us. So it doesn't look like it's disabled. There's our owner. Let's look at output as we go here. So lock ability and ability. So it's the same. Oh, why is lock ability still set? Are we not calling hide? Maybe hide's not getting called, guys. That's our problem. This is the old lock ability, right? So this locked owner is bad. So if we look at its game object, right, there's the missing reference object. That's our bug. Okay, so let me detach. Are we not calling hide? We should be calling hide in character UI. Oh, we actually don't call hide. We don't call hide. So I think I do want to put this in display. What's going on is we call hide when we cycle through the panels, but when we cycle through the heroes, we don't call hide. So instead, let's move this code up to here. So in display, if we have a lock ability, will this be all right? I want to call it before refresh, because refresh is destroying the old objects. I think that'll fix our bug. Do I do anything cool this week? No. No, I'm not cool. I don't do cool things. We learn. We're going to figure out how to fix that button, don't you worry. But more importantly now, if I click here, okay, good. And we can learn you. And I can, unfortunately, I can't keep clicking it now, but this was still enabled for a while. So we're good, right? We could flip, and we're good. We can flip, boom, all over the place. And we're good. All right. So why are we not getting our learn ability? It's supposed to be after 2 seconds we learn. So start a coroutine. We wait 3 seconds and then we disable the learn button. Let's see if that actually happens. So load game. I think it has something to do with us being clicked into the button. All right. So 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000. Boom, re-enables itself. So it's actually after 3 seconds, this gets rerun, which is very weird. Very, very weird. I wonder if I need to set the state after we disable the button. Maybe that's what I need to do. Let's try that. My pick came right on up. Dang, you guys, this is, you guys are vicious. Vicious today. Wow. Wow. All right, 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000, 4. We're still disabled. Okay, so that's all that our problem was here. So we can go fix this properly now. I think I can get rid of all of this. And if that's the case, we'll get rid of the coroutine altogether. Sorry, let me just get one here. And then I'll see if I can get rid of the coroutine. Test this out, then we'll test removing it. No surprise. I know, guys, I know. Vicious, no surprise. Boom, instantly is disabled. Okay, perfecto, which means this can all come back out. And NGUI. Problem solved yet again. I should do a Pokemon Go stream. Why would I do a Pokemon Go stream, Preston? You want to see me like walking around downtown Dallas trying to catch some Pokemon? Perfect. Is that what you want to see? Perfect. Ooh, this is so pretty now. This is so good. Yeah, so we need to get cost in here. Things like that. I think, what else do we need? I pick it up. Oh God, Preston. We need to do a straw poll. all right, you guys get to choose. You'll get to choose. Do you want me to do a Pokemon Go stream, or do you want to do Cooking with Wilkie? Those are your two choices. Let's check all this in. Oh, wow. Preston still wants that Pokemon Go. Everyone else wants a Cooking with Wilkie. How could you still choose? I don't know, Rad. I don't know. Cooking with Wilkie. Do I need a two-camera setup for Cooking with Wilkie, though? Hey, where did I learn C-sharp? I want to get into it, but sites like Code Academy don't have lessons on it. Well, okay, so Bland2K, where did I learn C-sharp? So I learned C-sharp during a time when there were zero tutorials. I started developing in C-sharp about 2001 time frame, early 2001, late 2000, I don't remember, it's a long time ago, when .NET beta, .NET 1.0 beta first hit the scene. That's when I started messing with .NET and C#. Because I want to know if you can really go outside. Preston, I can't. I can't. I'm allergic to the sun. The sun hurts. Definitely need two cameras. So rip the hat. What's the two cameras? Is there like an overhead camera that looks straight on to like whatever I'm doing, you know, cooking or prepping or whatever? And then there's a camera that's looking me in the face. But that's what I was about to, that's what I was thinking of, Preston. Yeah, Microsoft Virtual Academy has a pretty good C# learning tutorials, right? They have a learning series on how to learn C# from the ground up. Blam, 2K man, I'm old. I know. Thanks for rubbing it in, Blam. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. Man, you're old. Well, duh. All right, so I need two cameras. Obviously, I mean, I actually have two web cameras staring at me in the face, by the way. And one camera you. So I could do that. All right, Rad, have fun at church, buddy. That's a great resource for finding coding tutorials. That's true. So I need two cameras. The camera staring me at the face is easy. The camera looking down at what I'm doing. I would have to get some type of tripod, right, Rick? I would need to get some type of tripod that I can mount the camera on to look down at. I might have to do a little bit of research for Cooking with Wilkie. I might have to go inspect a cooking stream here on Twitch to see what they do. To see how they make the magic happen. It's a shopping spree time. Yeah, just an excuse to go buy some stuff, Rad. Exactly. Get a GoPro, Preston. Oh, now I gotta get a GoPro? Alright, how about the expected profession streamer judges? If I get a GoPro, should I just get a drone? Guys, maybe I should just get a drone that is sitting in my kitchen, staring at me and just following me around. And then that's the camera on me. And then I can have a camera looking at the food. Yeah, just have, yeah, right, drone. Drone in the kitchen seems about the correct setup that we need. I wonder how loud this would be. Just a drone sitting in my kitchen staring in hover mode, right? Hover and follow mode. It will go nice with the Roomba, Preston. Yeah, should the Roomba be running at the same time that I'm trying to cook? That sounds like a proper thing to do. Sounds like a proper thing to do. Get a diverse view of the food. Oh, four. I need four cameras now, or four drones with cameras. Wow. This is getting professional. Everyone does need a drone in 2017. I kind of feel that way, Jarvik. If you don't have a drone in 2017, where have you failed in life? I mean, just where? Where did life fail you? An adjustable arm clamp. Oh, you know, actually, when I think about that, Rick, I have one sitting right here, right? Oh, here, I'll put it into camera view and show you guys. Let me look at my camera. Right, I have a boom stand. Whoa, whoa, whoa. I don't know if you guys can see this or what is happening. Uh-oh, let me get it over here. There it is, right? I have a boom stand. And obviously my voice is gonna change here as I put this into view. Let me bring this down. I have a boom stand. That would actually work for what I wanna do from a camera looking down, because it has a mount on it. I can just mount a camera to it. Love the drone idea. Take a look at replacing a light bulb with a drone on YouTube. I'm gonna look that up, Rick. I know you're Preston. I know you got the drone game on lockdown. You are. You've definitely won at life for 2017. If drones are the key. But I do want to get a drone. Maybe this is my reason to going buy a drone is so that I can use it to stream my cooking channel. Wow. I need to post some new pictures too. Hold on, let's do this right now, guys. I know if anyone out there has my Instagram, if not, let me know. I'll give you my Instagram again. Let's post a new Instagram photo live on stream of some new food. Right? If anyone needs my link, just let me know. I gotta decide what I want to post. What did I post last? That's what I gotta look. Get a tiny Whoop. It's a super tiny FPF drone. All right, Preston. Look, I'm gonna come to you for all my for drone advice. That's what I'm gonna do. Where is my profile? Where are you at? There it is. Okay, that's what it was. Got it. Tiny Whoops and giant drone racing is the future of drones now. Cool. Drone for you because cooking has a lot of movement as you run around. You're also going to want a wireless mic as you run. Oh, either a wireless, I could get like a lapel mic, Rick. That's true. I need to get a wireless mic. Oh, man. The giant drones are scary. Called the Freedom Class. What? What the hell's a Freedom Class? All right, hold on. I got to decide what I want to post. Because I'm terrible at posting things on Instagram. I made some cod yesterday. All right, I think I'm going to post this cod that I made yesterday. It's pretty basic, but I think it'll do. I think it will do. Where's my filter? Everyone's got to have filters. Hold on. Well, I have a draft now I gotta go find, because I'm a moron. Where's my draft at? Where are you at? Where are you at, sir? There it is. Let's try that. No. All right, we're starting over. Guys, I'm starting over. I have failed at the Instagram. It's okay. Easy to fix, though. Mostly easy to fix. Boop. There we go. Hit next. And it is about to be posted. All right, there we go, guys. Posted on a... Giant drones or helicopters? A great place to use... Yeah, I know. Cooking never takes place close to walls, guys. This is what we are going to be cooking on my channel. There's my Instagram link. If you did Wilkie's drone cooking show, you'd revolution would have shamed all of the cooking streamers. Rick, how much damage do you think I could cause by having a drone sitting in my kitchen watching me? How much damage do you think that would cause? I'm curious. I am curious. Yeah. It tastes yummy too, my friend. Feel my mojo. Make scrambled eggs and you're fine. I like it. I'll just make some scrambled eggs. I like that. Tony Stark cooking streams. Preston, I gotta get in on this. I definitely need to get a wireless mic. I agree with that. Either a wireless mic or this drone needs to have like a good shotgun mic, right? Are there any drones that can attach to decent shotgun mic? I'd have a cooking streamer's hating on me. Oh, God. I'm going to start doing some research, everybody. I'm definitely going to start doing a little bit of research. Because, I mean, I want to get in on what's going on with all of this drone shenanigans. Okay. You could throw eggs into the props of the drone. Scrambled eggs. Oh, God, you guys. You could attach a shotgun to a drone. I don't want a beer boy. Not a shotgun. A shotgun mic. Many recipes out there to do something. You certainly don't want bugs around. Wah, wah, wah. Yeah, let's try and keep bug count at zero when we are cooking. That's good. It's a good analogy. Welcome to Pun Day, everybody. I think Dylan just won. Get paid? Is the cooking shows, is that where the money is, Ramses? Is the cooking shows where all the money is now? Well, we can close this down. IDLs, okay, make sure my IDL was checked in as well. You need a mic right next to the frying pan, Rick? But do I have, who's gonna switch between all the mics, Rick? I mean, you only want one live mic. Well, I mean, I guess you could, that's not true, right? You can mix a bunch of mics into a mix. That's true. You gotta be very careful if it's picking up your voice on several mics, because you can get weird effects that way. I'm just laughing on Instagram. It's only picks of food. What else would I post on Instagram, Preston? What would I post on Instagram? That's all I post there, man. My Instagram is purely for food. What else do people put on Instagram? I don't actually even know. In this day, like that cooking show with Snoop on it? Oh, right. I know, man. That is definitely my ticket to stardom. Cooking with drones. Yeah, Preston, it's all food I've cooked. Most of these cooking streamers that I watch don't go this far at all. All right. I should post a couple topless pics, Preston. I will get on that. But that's for you and you alone. That's for you and you alone, my friend. All right, guys. This, however, is going to be the end of our Sunday. We are going to be cutting the stream off right now. Oh, what's my favorite dish to cook, Beer Boy, before we leave? I don't have a favorite dish, Beer Boy. I like to try new things. It's the same. I don't like, what's the favorite dish to eat? I don't have a favorite food or favorite dish that I like to consume. Otherwise, that would be my favorite dish to make, because I usually cook most of the food I eat. I don't have a favorite dish to make. I like to change it up. I don't even have a favorite continent of food that I like to cook. I'll cook, you know, Thai food and Indonesian food. Obviously, a lot of American food. Right, I'm an American. So I like to change that up too. Cook a lot of Mediterranean food. I bake a lot. Now the question is going to be, when I do my cooking with Wilkie stream, is it cooking with Wilkie or is it baking with Wilkie? Oh, hold on. Creative cookie girlfriend. Do I want to know what this is, Rick? Rick, do I even want to know what this is? Oh, that's right. I kind of need that apron. That apron is where it's at. Sandwiches are the best. You can do whatever. Yeah, sandwiches, you know, pizza sandwich. A noodle sandwich. Yeah, you can do any kind of sandwich. Rick, I might have to pick that cooking apron up. That might be too good to pass. Yes. Yes. Show the stream? Oh, here we go. All right, hold on, guys. I don't know if I can show this on stream, Rick. I don't know if I can. So Rick would like me to purchase this apron. You want me to do baking with Bill? Oh my god. How to eat leftover pizza. Yeah, so I gotta do a little research on a drone. I need a drone. I need to see if I can get a drone with a shotgun mic on it so that I don't have to use a wireless mic. Or should I just get a do a wireless system? Is this the time where I invest in a lapel mic and wireless system? Oh my god. I already have a mixing board, so I could hook up multiple mics. I have lots of mics, so that's not a big deal. I have two cameras already, but if I get a drone, I gotta get a drone with a camera. So that would be another camera. This is too much. It's getting nuts in here, guys. Okay, everybody, though, I really am cutting it off for now. Gonna be calling it a day. It is Super Bowl Sunday. I have a bunch of errands I need to run, and then I'll be watching the game, which is in a few hours from now. Hope you guys had fun today. We got some work done, and then obviously we didn't get some work done, but that's fine. We got our leveling system in place. We can pick abilities. We can learn abilities. We show all of our abilities. The UI is there. It's good. I think we need to do the end of combat. So Wednesday I'll be back streaming, and we'll work on the post-combat screen, which tells us how much experience we get, if we leveled up, what gear we got, right? That's a big screen I want to do, and we'll be working on that on Wednesday. So hope you guys had fun. Mic stand works fine. No need to wait for drone. No, Fubark, need a drone. Drone important. Drone required for this to happen. But anyway, guys, happy Sunday. If anyone out there is going to be watching Super Bowl, enjoy the game. Be responsible. Drive safe. Stay safe. Until then, I will see you all next time.